And today we are going to be working on teaching your puppy to go to their spot or go to their mark, as I call it. So you can use just about anything. We're teaching Nova here to go to a platform. Slightly elevated surface is a little bit easier for your dog to learn how to get managed in the beginning. But down the road, you should be able to actually put a business card or a piece of paper on the ground and tell them to go to it, and they can figure it out. So by elevating it and just making a larger surface, we're just making it an easier spot to hit. So I'm going to grab Nova. Nova, come here. And if Nova wasn't very responsive to me, typically I would start on a leash and help walk her over to the item. But she seems, she's had a couple little practices with the platform, so I think she's trustworthy enough to walk up to this item. So what we're going to do is we just walk our dog flush up to the side of the platform, and we're just going to walk straight up here, signal to the mark, and give our verbal cue. So I say go to your mark. You can say go to your spot or park it, or you can kind of word it however you want. So every time my puppy makes it on the mark, he or she gets a treat always on the mark. So we're going to really, really reinforce that area. Any step off is just going to get a redirection back to the mark. If you have a dog that's very nervous about the new area that you're teaching them, every step on can get the treat in the beginning. So I always use a verbal secondary reinforcer such as yes or a clicker. So as soon as they take the first step on, they can get the click and the treat, or a yes and a click and the treat, and then you can form it one paw at a time if your dog is a little bit nervous to get on. But Nova has a little bit of a background on getting on these platforms, so I think she'll do fine. So we're going to call her over. Nova, come here, big girl. And we're going to see if we can just walk her flush up to the mark. Good girl. I just say, go to your mark. Yes. And I can be right on the edge of it in the beginning. Okay, so I can be right up here. Good mark. She doesn't have to do any position at this point. All she's got to do is learn how to get to it. So each time she gets to the mark, I'm just going to pull her off, signal to it again, and I'm going to back off the distance as she gets a little bit better. So we're going to try it again. Ready? Come on over here. And we're going to stop a little short. Go to your mark. Yes. Good girl. Good mark. Very good. And we would do it at each level, a little bit of a repetition. So I'm about a foot away now. I would do that until she's about 90% consistent with this level, and then I back it off to 2 feet. So we're just going to keep doing that a couple times. And we'll signal again. Good mark. Yes, good mark. And as I get a little bit farther distance away like that, I'm just going to always run up to her and make sure I always reward her on the mark. So if she kind of pops off a little bit, I'm just going to re-signal there. So we'll do it again. Good job. Good mark. Yes, good mark. Good girl. Now, as you back off distance with them, a lot of dogs will do kind of a halves. You go to your mark because they realize you have the reward, whether it's a pet or a treat or a toy, and they also are having to learn to go away from you, which is not some dog's favorite thing, especially if they're a Velcro dog. So if you are, say, a good 4 to 6 feet away, and you send your dog, and they go directly halfway in between and sit, that's pretty normal. Some dogs will even go right to the edge of the mark and sit directly in front of it. That's okay too. All you want to do is just give them one point, one baby step and one point, and you can reiterate your verbal cue again if you want. But don't give them any more than one step, and see if they can kind of get that on their own. Sorry, she's stealing cardboard boxes in the background when we're giving her breaks. So we're gonna try one more time, back it off really good, and see if she can go to her mark. So we're gonna come on off. Yes, girl. And go to your mark. Yes, and sit. Good girl. And now I'm adding a sit in, and that's just because down the road, once she knows not to leave this platform, I can start doing distance work with my dog very, very quickly. So if you have a very well-trained dog who knows not to leave this area, then you can start doing your sits and downs and spins and whatever you want to teach them from way across the room and add distance to how you give your cues very, very quickly as opposed to if you were just starting to practice with it on the floor. So it's a useful tool in a lot of different ways. So I hope you enjoyed doing a park it or a go to your mark trick this week and get a little bit of distance on your dog and have some fun with it. So with our dogs in our house, what we typically do is put this platform at the end of our hallway. And I call it bowling dogs. We get them really, really excited. We run them up the hallway and I just go work it. So it kind of gives them a lot of added momentum to get to that area and they start learning how to get there quickly. In your first week, really, really reinforce this area. So I might give a special reward if they get a bone once a week. That's their special thing. I'm going to send them to that area first to retrieve it. If they want to go for walks and they get excited when they put their leash on, I might put them there to retrieve it. But if their favorite thing is when I get home from work and they get a massage, then they're going to have to go to the mark first to receive it. So this place is now, I call it magnetizing the mark. It's now the new hot spot to be in the house, and it'll really help you with a lot of different areas of keeping your dog off furniture and things of that nature. So have fun practicing this week, and we will see you guys on the next trick. Right?